in our 163rd year in service to America. Ladies and gentlemen, this is your United States Naval Academy Band. Welcome the 30th leader of the Navy's oldest and finest band, from Buffalo, New York, Lieutenant Diane Nichols. Once again to welcome you to the latest installment of Summer Serenade 2015, brought to you by the Mayor of the City of Annapolis in cooperation with the Superintendent of the United States Naval Academy. This evening's performance is one of our long-standing traditions, our annual alumni concert. Tonight, past members of the band return to take their places on stage for an evening of great music, fellowship, and fond memories. This evening, you'll hear from our full, extremely well-staffed wind ensemble. You'll hear from our alumni Dixieland band, the original Crabtown Stompers. Woo-hoo! Our alumni big band, the Next Wave. So there's lots to do this evening, so let's get right down to business. The march you just heard was written by America's March King, John Philip Sousa, and is titled The Black Horse Troop. Sousa was a great lover of horses, despite the fact that a fall from a high-spirited horse in 1921 caused him limited use of his left arm for the rest of his life. Sousa wrote this march in 1924 and dedicated it to the Cleveland National Guard. When Sousa's band premiered the march in Cleveland in 1925, the troopers rode their beautiful black horses right up to the stage. To introduce our next selection and our guest conductor for this evening, I want to introduce a great friend who was my predecessor at the microphone. He was also a mentor to me when I first reported to USNA Band in 1979. Ladies and gentlemen, from Wrightsville, Pennsylvania, please give a warm welcome to Master Chief Musician Ron Cohen, United States Navy retired.
Thank you, Gary. And thank you, ladies and gentlemen, for joining with the Naval Academy Band and so many of our alumni for this fabulous evening together. I'm really excited, aren't you? All right. James Curnow is the president, composer, and educational consultant for Curnow Music Press, and serves also as composer in residence on the faculty of Asbury University in Wilmore, Kentucky. He's written a trove of selected compositions for brass bands. And to conduct this exciting work, I'm pleased to introduce the Naval Academy Band's 26th leader. He started in March 2005, and he served through 2007. Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in welcoming back to the stage Lieutenant Commander Mel Kessler.
Thank you.
Two, when composer Peter Lehman was having dinner with a group of these paratroopers, he was asked to compose a march for them. And in one night, in one evening, the Belgian paratroopers' march was written in their honor. Must be nice to have a lot of towel like that, huh? Anyway, 52 years ago, it's just a small thing for us, you know, we're alumni, we don't go back now. 52 years ago began the unofficial formation of the original Crabtown Stompers. How many remember the Crabtown Stompers, the original ones? Well, there are a couple here, still alive, that's good. Well, anyway, its first member was Senior Chief Henning Honey back in 1963. And he was joined in 1964. Now, if I read these names and you remember some of them, go ahead and clap, just let me know you know who they were. In 1964, he was joined on trumpet by Mac McLean. Anybody remember that name? And then he was joined by Emmett Wright on the trombone. Bob Simmons, who was affectionately known by all of us in the band as Rabbit, on tuba. And then there was Dick Bonifon on drums. Anybody remember Dick? Yes, okay. And then Phil Cook rounded the group out on piano. Now, I don't know how many of you know this or not, but this group began by the name of Midweek Crisis. I don't know about that name. I mean, I don't know if I'd go see a group that was named Midweek Crisis, but anyway, that's what they were named. And they used to play at the Officers Club and Buzzy's Pizza Parlor. How many of you remember Buzzy's Pizza Parlor that was outside of Gate 3? Well, that's where they used to play. And it quickly became obvious that this group needed to become an official part of the band's performance ensembles. And so Henning dubbed them the original Crabtown Stompers. That's their name to this day, minus the word original. Senior Chief Honey led that group until his retirement in 1980, which was the same year that we both retired, after having served so many years together. Well, joined this evening by Lieutenant Commander John Fluck, retired on piano. And by the way, Mr. Fluck was the band's leader from August of 1988 until his retirement in July of 1989. And he'll be playing the piano. And then we got Senior Chief Dick Glass, retired on banjo. You can go ahead and... Then you got Senior Chief Scott Ragsdale, retired on trombone.
Scotty Poo!
You got your cheering sections out here tonight. That's really good. Then you got Master Chief Gary Wolf, retired on trumpet and co-MC. And then you got Chief Max Murray, retired on the bass. Well, ladies and gentlemen, it's my special privilege this evening. I'm going to ask you to join with myself in welcoming back these alumni and my friend and colleague, retired Senior Chief Henning Honey on clarinet, who began that wonderful toe-tapping Dixieland group so many years ago. Here are, at least partially, the original Crabtown song.
We have to make one addition. Somehow it fell off the cue card back there. How about a big hand for retired Mr. Mike Beagle? So, go with me if you will, please. We're going back about 51 years, and it was a rainy Wednesday afternoon, sometime in late 1964, and the band had just come back from doing their noon concert on the Chapel Rock bandstand. How many of you know that used to be a band that played there? They still do, actually. And we were all sitting around the rehearsal room, anxiously awaiting on the word about the upcoming 3 o'clock parade on Borden Field, which we were hoping would be canceled. And I was nodding off like I usually do, and then all of a sudden, I heard this. Sing a little song for you. This is something that was written actually up the street in Baltimore in the early part of the last century. So I'm sure I think you'll recognize it when you hear it. gentlemen, I see the steamer coming, heading here to this pier. If you hurry, we'll make it, never fear, on the Old Dominion line. Ain't she sailing pretty as she hacks the shore, heading for Old Baltimore. See those paddles turning, hear those waters churning, she's the queen of Chesapeake Bay. Come on, Nancy, put your best dress on. Come on, Nancy, for the steamboat's gone. Everything is lovely on the Chesapeake Bay. All aboard for Baltimore, and if we're late, we'll all be sure. Now look here, Captain, let us catch that boat. We can't swim, and listen, we can't float. Banjo strum and a good old tune. Up on deck is the place to spoon. Rolled up close beneath the silvery moon, sailing down the Chesapeake Bay. See the smoke pouring from her funnels gay. Honey, ain't that sight just grand? So put your bib and tuck her on and come with me. Sights we'll see, oh. Hear those sails churning, hear those waters churning. She's the queen of Chesapeake Bay. Come on, Nancy, put your best dress on. Come on, Nancy, for the steamboat's gone. Everything is lovely on the Chesapeake Bay. All aboard for Baltimore, and if we're late, they'll all be gone. Now look here, Captain, let us catch that boat. We can't swim in this, we can't float. Lovers have and a good old tune. Up on deck is the place to spoon. Paddle up close beneath the silvery moon. Going down the Chesapeake, heading down the Chesapeake. Sailing down Chesapeake Bay. All aboard. Thank you. great, ladies and gentlemen.
Who came all the way down here from Pennsylvania on the tenor sax. Somehow he got left off the hook.